In this episode, I will build a section of fourth catapult of an aircraft carrier in 72 scale. But it's not a plastic kit. I'm gonna design, print, and build. Enjoy the video. I'm starting with the design. Yes, I use Blender for that. Actually, it's a 3D design software for game developers and animation movie makers. Designing a scale part in Blender is a real pain in the neck, but it has so many advantages for faster designing than any CAD software. Now I'm showing you some of them. Of course, I'm not gonna show you the whole design process. Here it's Jet Blast Deflector after a few hours work. This is Array Modifier, which makes life easier for me. And finally, this is Extrude Feature of Blender. This one is my favorite. After about 2 weeks, I completed the design process. Here it's the result. This is Lychee slicing software. It has some awesome features. It can fix mesh issues. It has also a magic tool for auto-placing, supporting, and it works. Only one problem left. I need a bigger 3D printer than my Anycubic Mono. And here it is, my new Anycubic Mono X. Let's prepare it for the print process. I tighten each screw evenly and in 4 steps. The biggest mistake you can make is tighten each screw to the end in one go. Mono X comes with an aluminum tray and it makes huge difference. I recommend you upgrade your plastic tray of Mono with aluminum one immediately. Let the first print begin. These huge parts need a huge wash tank. This is Anycubic Wash & Cure Plus, wash & cure machine for Mono X. The biggest difference from the smaller version, apart from its size, the whirlpool it creates is way stronger. Parts look perfectly clean. I use this blade instead of murder weapon comes with the printer. In order to prevent deformation in the parts, I quickly switch to the curing process without waiting too long. Yes, I can now start mass production. The plates were deformed after they had cured completely. It's totally my fault. In order not to waste too much resin, I was stingy and did not design thick and supportive the back surfaces to prevent deformation. It doesn't matter, no problem, I'll fix that. I fixed them on a foam plate and let them cure for about 24 hours. At that time, I cleaned all the remaining parts and prepared them for assembly. After the leveling process, which consisted of a series of putty and sanding operations, was finished, the deck was ready. Now I am adding tarmac texture with a sanding stick. I'm covering the edges with balsa wood. And I'm covering the front side with a plastic plate. I'm covering the corner with a plastic profile. And it's ready to assembly. To glue the parts that I designed and print in 3D one by one. This was really a pleasure. Finally, it's ready for paint. I'm starting with the primer coat as usual. I'm painting the tarmac surface with rubber black first. Then I'm painting with dark gray irregularly. After the tarmac paint is completed, I mask the entire surface and painting the remaining details. I'm painting the side details with gray. After the paint has completed, now I'm applying gloss varnish to protect the paint. Now I'm applying a heavy weathering wash. This time I'm repainting over on it with highly diluted paint instead of wiping the excess wash. This is kind of pre-shade weathering technique, which I use on small ship models. I'm painting metal details. And more post-shade weathering. Finally, I can apply the flat varnish layer. More post-shade weathering. With this silicone tool, I'm adding some tire track effects to the surface. By the way, sorry if you clicked on the video thumbnail to watch the build of F-14A. I built it last year, but that's okay, you can still watch it. The video link is in the sidebar or the information section below. Also, figures are from the Italeri pilot and ground crew set. Well, thanks for watching this episode. If you liked the video, please like and share. Subscribe my channel if you haven't yet. Also, you can support my channel if you can see the join button below or on Patreon. The links are in the information section below. See you soon on the next episode. Until then, take care of yourself and keep modeling. Bye.